Hey everybody. So today, I think you can probably figure out where I'm at out here in City of Irvine Open Space Preserve. We're in Bommer Canyon up near the cattle camp right now and getting ready to head out on the trails. We're gonna do East Fork and Ridge Route, maybe a little bit of Hogback, and then we'll do the Nature Garden too because that's looking pretty spectacular right now. Really, this is sort of where it all began for both Mr. Irvine and his family and the beginnings of the Irvine Ranch. So I'm gonna go get my pack on, get all my gear ready to go, and we're gonna hit the trails. So this lower section of East Fork right here, right inside the gate, is one of our newest restoration sites. And there's been a weed removal. This area was pretty much non-native grasses, a lot of mustard you can see up on the hills. A lot of that, well, the weeds were removed. And then these areas right along in here were planted. There's a nice mix of coastal sage scrub species. There's some California sagebrush. You remember from the farm, that's my favorite. It's a beautiful smell, wonderful cowboy cologne. And there's some, looks like some black sage, maybe some other types of sage, some everlasting in here, some monkey flower, which is cool. It's a nice little orangey coastal monkey flower here. And all sorts of great stuff going on out here. There is a beautiful bush sunflower, California encelia. Nice and bright, very nice. We're doing the East Fork Ridge Route, as I mentioned, and so we're headed up East Fork. And it's probably one of the more popular routes here in Bommer that we use for a lot of different activities. It's a really nice trail. East Fork, single track, and then Ridge Route's also single track, which is great. So it's nice and intimate. It has fantastic coastal sage scrub. As you can see, we're kind of walking up here into a nice shady spot as well under the oaks. One of my favorite spots along this trail. Generally, pretty decent wildlife, good birds. Been hearing lots of reports of snakes, rattlesnakes. So definitely gonna be keeping my eye out. And it is May, so the marine layer is just starting its pattern, right? May gray, June gloom. But even though we have some sort of kind of negative names for it, it's really a really great part of our climate. That marine layer system is very important, provides really good moisture for our local plant species here as they're getting ready to go into the long summer. So here we are into our oaks. You might notice some burn scarring, especially on this one right here. It's real nice and close to the trail. But the last time this area burned was in 1993, the Laguna Canyon fire. So Bommer and Shady Canyon especially are really good examples of what a mature, recovered coastal sage scrub plant community would and should look like. Being that it's been almost 30 years since that last fire, you get some really, really nice, dense, and very diverse hillsides like this one above. This is what our hillside should look like around here. As long as we can keep that fire frequency down a little bit, closer to more of a natural scale of once every 30 to 50 years, this is what our natural open spaces would look like. So again, great example of a mature, intact coastal sage scrub system down here in Bommer. Always got to take a chance on a warm day and take whatever shade you can get. Enjoy it for as long as you can before you move on. And I know I mentioned earlier the marine layer being very important. And that marine layer is part of our sort of overall climate system, which we are a Mediterranean climate zone. So like its namesake, the Mediterranean would be one other. There are only 5 Mediterranean climate zones on the planet, and we are one of those. You have the Mediterranean basin, of course, as I mentioned. And then down in the southern hemisphere, you have the coast of Chile, the coast, southern and western coasts of Australia, and South Africa. And if you look on a map, on a globe, you might notice that there are some commonalities in all of them. West coasts, about the same latitude, northern and southern borders. And they all have very, very similar vegetation because that pattern creates a very temperate climate type system where you have very short, mild, wet winters and very long, hot, dry summers. And the Mediterranean climate zones are only about 2% of the world's land mass, dry land mass, but make up over 20% of the world's known plant species. So you have a very rare location, very rare climate, and therefore you have very rare and specifically adapted plants to that system. And then you throw in, again, that beautiful weather and all the people that want to live there. It's great for agriculture. It's great for sports and hiking and all sorts of outdoor activities and the ranching. And so it makes for a very desired place from a human element too. So there's a lot of pressure on these very rare and very threatened now ecosystems. So coastal sage scrub is really kind of what started it all as far as the protection under the MCCP, which dates back to the early 90s, was set in place to protect coastal sage scrub habitat, to therefore protect some of the threatened and endangered species that reside within it and require it for their survival, namely the gnatcatcher, coastal cactus wren, and orange-throated whiptail lizard. So we always want to keep that in mind when we're out here recreating, try to make sure that we minimize our presence as much as possible. Just a really special view for me. And even Mr. Irvine, like I had said at the beginning, this is kind of where it all started for him, was back in the late 1800s with his partners from San Francisco, decided to buy up what was then known as Rancho San Joaquin from Jose Andres Sepulveda, who was had been given a Spanish land grant and was ranching the area even then in the mid to late 1800s. So Mr. Irvine came in and he's purported a saying at one point along the way that from one of these tall hillsides where he was overlooking the view of his ranch, and supposedly said, "This is the most delightful land I've ever seen." So that's looking back towards cattle camp, down out towards those kind of hills in the middle is Turtle Rock, the community of Turtle Rock. And then beyond that, the city of Irvine, kind of looking towards South Coast. And on a real clear day, you might even be able to see you definitely see the San Gabriels, possibly even all the way to downtown LA on nice clear days. But this is the view from the top of East Fork. It's pretty fantastic. This spot up here on East Fork is well known for several chalk dudleas that grow right up here on the top, right alongside the trail. This is one of them. Wow, this thing is just humongous and has these beautiful arms that will produce some flowers, beautiful red, scarlet red flowers. And then after that stalk has bloomed and been pollinated, it will then die off. But this is the chalk dudleya. There's several, of course, types of dudleya, different types of succulents in our area. Some are really, really rare, and especially speaking, the one that grows over the hill there, the Laguna Beach dudleya, grows in one specific spot and is endemic to that location. So it's one of the neat things, again, with our rare threatened ecosystem. We do have a lot of what are called endemic species that grow here and nowhere else naturally. So these white flowers in front of us, that's the everlasting. And I still have a little bit to go. All right, so here we're at the top of East Fork where it intersects with the Ridge Route Trail and also the Hogback Ridge Trail, which is over to the right. And that's where we're gonna go just for a little bit so we can get a nice view and down, looking down into Shady Canyon. So we're gonna head off here over toward on Hogback for just a little bit, and let's see what we can see. All right, so we're out on Hogback Ridge, and from Hogback you have a nice view looking down into Shady Canyon, which is again part of City of Irvine Open Space Preserve. And Shady Canyon has several single tracks that drop down off of Serrano Ridge, which is right along this ridge right here. Serrano Ridge Trail or Road kind of creates the border between the City of Irvine Open Space and Laguna Coast Wilderness Park, which is a county park. And Serrano Ridge is open 7 days. But on this side of the ridge, to the west side, is City of Irvine Open Space. And on the east side would be Laguna Coast Wilderness Park. Some really, really nice trails. These trails, this whole area is a bit of an elevated protected status. And so the only access to those trails is by guided program only and during wilderness access days. So Bommer is sort of the headquarters when we're running our Bommer Canyon wilderness access days every third Saturday. Fantastic area, really, really pretty. Like I had said, just really great intact coastal sage scrub. You can tell just that kind of mosaic patch of big shrubs and little spotty grasslands and even some strips of oaks down in the lower valley part where there's a little bit more moisture. But just a really, really nice example of what a mature coastal sage scrub plant community should look like. Ridge route again, really nice little single track, has some great views. I love this trail in the evenings, especially during full moon hikes. The full moon be coming up over the Santa Ana Mountains off to your right, to the east there. And as you walk down this, you walk kind of towards all the city lights, and it's just a really, really pretty spot to be hiking in the evenings. Full moon hikes are pretty popular. I love those. So we have this perfect little 3 mile loop, East Fork Ridge Route. Some people prefer to come up Ridge Route because it's a little bit easier to climb. It just means you have to do the steep descent down East Fork. Either way, really can't go wrong. Great little loop up here. And here's our sagebrush, our cowboy cologne. So I'm gonna freshen up a little bit with that. Just grab a little hand, rub it, and just dab that on the cheeks and chin. Cowboy cologne, love it. And I know I had mentioned earlier, this was kind of where James Irvine got started, was initially with the purchase of Rancho San Joaquin down here along the coast, and then added Rancho Las Lomas or Lomas de Santiago to the north, and then parts of Rancho Santiago de Santa Ana as well. And all told, when he was done putting all those pieces together, it was over 90,000 acres. Some books even say as much as 110,000 acres, all completely under his ownership and stretched literally from the mountains to the sea, from the Santa Ana Mountains up there around where the toll road now meets the 91 freeway, Coal Canyon area, all the way down to the Pacific coast of Newport and Crystal Cove and Laguna. And so pretty remarkable, really. Think about that any of this is still protected when you start to kind of look at things. But over time, it started with sheep, just like Sepulveda and some of the other Mexican ranchos that were here before him. Started with sheep and then was farming the valley, which is where Irvine now sits along the San Diego Creek Channel, and then into cattle as well, raising cattle out here on the hillsides. And then the Irvine Company started moving into development. And initially, we're only going to protect about 10% of that 100,000 acres. Later on, as things started to change, they changed course on that and now have preserved over half, so over 40,000 acres within that original, more than that is protected. 40,000 is what makes up the landmarks, but over 50,000 is set aside as different forms of open space. And so half of the original ranch is now protected and undeveloped. And part of that is here is the City of Irvine Open Space Preserve. All right, we're gonna head down the rest of Ridge Route and we're gonna go check out the Bommer Nature Garden. Usually one of the first implements that people notice are the cattle chutes, where the trucks would pull up and be able to unload and load up the cattle, and they were coming in and off the ranch. So there's a metal one here. And then as you go around the corner towards the entrance to the garden, there's an old wooden one. It's pretty neat, still intact. A lot of the implements that are here are being left sort of in an element of arrested decay. We're hoping to kind of maintain them as they are. Still people give people a glimpse into the history of the area. And So we're gonna make our way over to the garden entrance. So here we are in the Mage Garden. Looks like the azalea is just going crazy. It's beautiful. Big sunflower blooms. As you walk down this first little corridor off to the left, you see some old wooden fencing, but behind it, hopefully I can get out there, a little concrete structure. It looks like it has actually two ramps, one on each end, and it's two concrete walls, and inside there is a trench. And that trench is deep enough to be filled. It would have been filled with a liquid, disinfectant cleaning liquid, and cattle would have been forced to swim through that trench. It's called a dipping trough, and it would have enabled them to clean off any ticks or other issues that would have presented problems on the ranch. So it was a way of disinfecting and cleaning up the cattle before they were released into the rest of the herd. They would have been soaked wet, and they would come up here onto the drying platform. And it might be hard to tell in the video here, but it is angled so that as the cattle were drip drying up on the concrete platform, the liquid would then have flowed back into the trench. So that's dipping trough and our drying platform. Oh, little bunny. And coyote brush and black sage, some mule fat. These are still elderberries here. Wow. They're humongous. Everlasting. Some sumac in here. Sagebrush, of course. There's some cactus, prickly pear cactus. So it's a really nice sampling of lots of our different native plant communities. This is called a squeeze shoot and is used even still today on many ranches. It is a mechanism for ranchers to be able to treat their cattle safely so they can push the cattle into this implement here. Their head would go straight through the middle and out between those two bars. That arched bar would then close down around the top of their head and hold them in place. And then these sides can be raised and lowered and the bars taken off so that the vets and ranchers can then work on the cattle from a safe area. So they would do things like inoculations and check for calves and things of that nature for taking care of the cattle. So that's a squeeze chute. Okay, so that concludes our tour of Bommer Canyon, the East Fork Ridge Route Loop, and the Bommer Nature Garden. Hope you enjoyed it. It was a beautiful day out here. A little bit warm, but nice cool breeze. Trails were in great shape. Plants are just gorgeous and green and blooming, and it was really nice. I really enjoyed sharing it with you, and I hope you get a chance to come out and check out Bommer Canyon soon. See you guys.